Had a very interesting question. She said that while she was going to perform Umrah, her plan initially was to go to Al-Madinah first. Then from there, she would assume an intention of Ihram from the proper Miqat of Al-Madinah, which is Dhul Hulaifa or Abi Yar Ali, as is known today. Then come to perform Umrah. But the plan has changed. When she landed to Jeddah airport, she did not find a flight. And she ended up making an intention of Umrah from Jeddah, which is not her miqat. Does she owe any penalty? First of all, if any person was going from any destination to Al-Madinah first, then decided to come from Al-Madinah to perform Umrah, so Al-Miqat will be more befitting to do the Ihram from Dhul Hulaifa. If any person visited Jeddah for business, for trade, for whatever reason, and he had no intention of performing Umrah, then all of a sudden they decided to initiate an intention of performing Umrah, then they may assume the intention of performing Umrah or Hajj from Jeddah. They don't have to return back to their miqat, because they become like resident temporarily in Jeddah. The case here is neither this nor that. She was planning to go to Al-Madinah. So I'd say that even if you did not find a flight, you should have taken any means of transportation, go by bus or a private cab or whatever to Al-Madinah. But the general ruling, if any person was in Jeddah, not for the intention of performing Umrah, he had another destination or whatever, he was stranded there, there's no flights, there's a flood like nowadays, could not go to Al-Madinah, then in this case, your Umrah and Ihram is valid, and you don't have to offer any penalty because you did not deliberately skip the miqat and arrive to Jeddah, whether knowingly or unknowingly. As far as you try to catch up and you say the intention while you are in the plane, it doesn't make any difference because you already passed your miqat. So if you did not intend initially to come to Jeddah and from there to perform Umrah, it was not your plan, but out of your control that you ended up in Jeddah, then in this case, inshallah, you do not owe any fidya. It was not your intention. But you should have taken any other means of transportation to go to Al-Madinah, make your visit, then assume the intention of Ihram from Abi Yar Ali.